Describe the internal structure of a dorsally ventral leaf with the help of a label diagram. So the dorso-ventrally leaf, so such kind of leaf is found in the dicot plants. So dorsal means the upper region. So this upper region is called dorsal and the lower region is called ventral. Now in dicot plants, the leaf is very thin and flat. It is flat both on the dorsal and the ventral region. So now the leaf is covered both on the dorsal and the ventral region. The leaf is covered by an outer protective layer called epidermis. So this epidermis is present both on the upper surface as well as lower surface. So the upper epidermis, it is also called as upper epidermis and lower epidermis. So generally, based on this, we can divide the leaf into three parts. So the one is the outer surface, that is epidermis, and the second one is the middle portion, which is called mesophyll, and the third one is the vascular bundles. So leaf we can divide into three parts: epidermis, mesophyll, and the vascular bundles. So first let us see what is an epidermis. So as I told, epidermis is the outermost covering layer of the leaf. So we can find upper and lower epidermis. So both upper and lower epidermis is covered by a protective thick layer. So this green color structure, is called cuticle. So the cells in the epidermis secrete a thick waxy substance called cuticle. So this cuticle prevents water and other substances from the atmosphere to enter inside the leaf and from the leaf to release into the atmosphere. So it acts as a protective layer. So it acts as a barrier. And on the lower surface as well as upper surface, there is a presence of stomata. So stomata are the minute pores through which transpiration takes place. So majorly stomata are found on the lower surface, and it is also present on the upper surface, but the number of stomata is less. And now coming to the middle part. So this, the cells between the upper and lower epidermis is called mesophyll. The region which is present between upper and lower epidermis, we call it as mesophyll. And mesophyll contains different types of cells, and these cells have chloroplast within it. So the cells are type of a parenchyma cell in which chloroplast is present. So these cells, we generally call it as chlorenchyma. And based on the arrangement, now this chlorenchyma is again divided into two types. So one is called, so here you can see some cells are parallelly arranged to one another. So these are called pellucid parenchyma. And in just below that, we can see the cells are loosely arranged with lot number of air cavity. So this is called spongy parenchyma. So mesophyll contains two types of cells, pellucid and spongy. Both are a type of parenchyma cells which has got chloroplast in it, and they are the main cells which can undergo photosynthesis. So pellucid and loosely arranged spongy parenchyma. So we learned about this. So these are pellucid and these are spongy. So main difference is about in the shape and the arrangement. Pellucid is elongated and parallelly arranged. Spongy is more of oval and they are loosely arranged. Now coming to the last part, vascular tissue. So in the mesophyll region, we can find the presence of vascular bundles, that is xylem and phloem. So the xylem and phloem brings water and minerals to the leaf, and the food which is synthesized in the leaf will be transported to other parts. So this is present in the veins. So the vascular bundles here are conjoined and closed. Closed in the sense there is no presence of cambium, and conjoined, they have a common axis. They are present on the common radius.